This is Alley Activation as a Neighborhood Sustainability Strategy. My name is Amina Mikula. I worked with Dr. Paul Drouse on this project throughout the summer. So what we really wanted to do in this project was beautify and reimagine the alleys in a neighborhood in West Detroit. We wanted to improve the quality of life socially by having spaces for residents to connect with one another and form relationships. Environmentally, we could help pollinators with butterfly gardens. We could mitigate water runoff, and we could reduce heat island effect with our gardens. And economically, we could encourage more people to move into the neighborhood, and businesses could benefit as well. We partnered with many associations to get a lot of things done. So the location of the 18 total alleys is Outer Drive and 6 Mile. There are 230 total households and businesses in the neighborhood association that share these alleys. There are 18 total. I'm going to focus on talking about 4 today. So this was the plan throughout the summer. I will go through each of these in depth throughout my presentation. But I first want to talk about the Butterfly Alley, which is one of the alleys in between Snowden and Littlefield Street. For this alley, we really wanted to make butterfly gardens, have pollinator plants, encourage the growth of wild milkweed, and put in a windmill by Santa Maria that will eventually generate power. Next is the Green Getaway Alley, which is across the street, across Santa Maria from the windmill. And here we have rain barrels, a rain garden, a mural, bus shelter. Next is the Reed Alley. This one caters more to children in the neighborhood. We want to have games, educational opportunities, learning about the plants there, and a little public library box. Across the street from there is the Bee Unique Alley, with a flow hive for bees where honey can be harvested. We're still in the process of getting that. The council circle, where residents can gather and converse. And then goats, which was kind of a funny idea, but goats could mow the alleyways for us. So it is still something we're talking about. So Dr. Drouse and I conducted 2 interviews with 2 residents in the neighborhood association to learn more about the history of the neighborhood, what they would like to see, what they wouldn't like to see. And we learned that it used to be a very bustling neighborhood socially. People would be walking around the businesses, but now it's more quiet and serene. The residents, though, are really looking forward to the butterfly gardens and everything we have planned. They want to encourage other residents to take care of their properties, and that in turn will encourage more people to move in. And it's a very safe neighborhood, and they want to keep it that way by showing activity in the alleys. So here are some before pictures of the alleyways. They're mainly used for storage, trash, just walk through if you could even walk through it. But we would have cleanup and conversation every 2 weeks where we would go in and clean out the alleys. And it was also a time for us to build relationships with the residents. So then we got the greenways after we cleaned out the alleyways. You can see all the way down. They're very clean, really nice. But what we really wanted to get to are dreamways. We installed some gates, and it's a little hard to see in these pictures, but we've got some plants lined up. We're still in the process of getting everything we want in the dreamways, but we're making a lot of progress this month. I want to show real quick the rain barrel installation. This garage is across the street from the windmill, and we'll have 2 rain barrels, a rain garden, and a mural on this garage. We also use virtual reality throughout this project. We had Oculus goggles and models that were made in SketchUp, so we could look at the alleys through the goggles and make changes in real time. This is still something we're perfecting, but it's been a really cool part of the project. Next, we did a survey so I could do some statistical analysis for this project. The data we had was from one of Dr. Drouse's previous classes, where the survey was given to neighborhoods on the west side of Detroit. We're still waiting for responses from the neighborhood association, but In the meantime, I used RStudio to analyze the data that we do have so we can compare it to the responses from the neighborhood association and see the changes in responses after the alleys have been activated and as we continue activating them. So I used RStudio to make these graphs. I first wanted to look at the relationship between questions to see if we're getting the responses we would expect. This shows us like the validity of our survey and ways we could improve it. So first I looked at questions 17 and 23. You would expect that if you agree you have a close-knit neighborhood, you would expect the resident to agree that neighbors can be counted on. So we found that by running a Fisher's test for association, there's enough evidence to say that these questions are related for the neighborhood of Brightmore. And we cannot say this for the neighborhood of Cody Rouge and Warrendale. This makes sense because we knew Brightmore was more connected as a community. They were spending more time like beautifying their neighborhood while Cody Rouge was not. And there's more spread in the Cody Rouge data. So it's just interesting looking at the differences between the neighborhoods and see how else we can improve the survey by asking different questions. So on that, we just wanna really identify the dimensions we're measuring, connectedness to nature, sense of community. Those last two questions were sense of community, mental health, physical health. So we can get a baseline of what residents are feeling before alley activation and then as that proceeds. And it would be nice to get some random sampling going because in the last survey, it was perhaps a little biased because we had residents kind of, it wasn't random sample. So it would be better in the future if we could do that. And I really want to touch on our showcase that we have at the end of this month. It's Tuesday, September 28th. We're going to have live music from the DSO, a local jazz rock band. We'll have a virtual reality presentation. We'll be showing the plants. We got a scavenger hunt for kids. So you can learn about all the plants there that have medicinal purposes that you can eat. We'll have response boards also to learn what else people would like to see. There's still a lot more that can be done, like the public library, council circle. We found out recently that we can beautify the islands that are right on Outer Drive, right next to the neighborhood. We can add flowers and plants there. So we can definitely like figure out what we want to do there. But that's everything on this project that I wanted to share in my short time. So thank you so much.